Hello everyone, I'm Greeklook, thank you for joining me, and welcome back to Krastorio for episode 23. So last episode we spent a lot of time setting up logistics for our character, and I think we'll just go with that for now. Wait a bit with running the last thing through, but we do need some research. What do we want? Were we working towards anything? I guess stuff like this is good anyways. So yeah, we actually got some robots up. And have them bring us stuff now. What is our next step? Maybe we should be working towards the next tech cards, or maybe we should still be working on trains that I started talking about like 5 episodes ago. Is that what we want? Or should we just build in some more iron and copper? The only reason for trains would be to get everything in good amounts. It will take an episode or two to set that up, I guess, but could also just go for a very simple setup, just with some rails up here, some down here, a station for iron, a station for copper, and then finding some coal somewhere that is not directly in front of our bus. And I guess we also need rare raw rare metals. I think we should go and do that, just so we don't run out of resources anytime soon. And I guess we don't really need this many locomotives. Let's go with 5 for now, which means we need 10 wagons, and I guess we just need all the signals and large or big electric poles. And yeah, we have construction robots as well. Which means that we should probably remove unnecessary blueprints around the place, or ghost images that we don't really want to build right now. Good, good. Let's start by planning a train depot for delivering the resources. Do we just put that up here? I guess. So we will have to reserve some space for the actual resources before the smelting columns, so shouldn't go any further up than around here. Where's it? Did I not take the rail? God dang it. Next research. Faster robots is a great thing. That's the rail. Let's help the robots a bit. Come on, do it, robots. Faster, faster, faster. And even faster than that. The first research actually helps quite a lot. And the next is... Is that 40% more or a total of 40%? Bonuses. Movement speed 35. Hopefully the next is 40 and not just another 30 or 5%, sorry, to a total of 40. But I think that is the case, because already having 75% bonus would, at least to me, seems a bit much. So the thought with these train stations. Either we have the train stop here, or one of the trains stop here, output resources, and then continue off. Or we have them come up, all of them come up this line, turn around and stop here somewhere. So, a little something like this, I guess. Actually pretty perfect. Question is if I want to try new stuff with trains, or I just want to do my old two hits for cards. We could also try double-headed trains. That would get rid of this whole section down here. But of course I will probably utilize that for... the unloading anyway of this train. We don't really need this warehouse here. Let's just manually unload. No, we can't actually. We will have to wait for the robots to come. Oh, poor robots running out of power. Do we only have junk chests up here then? I guess. Remove all of the junk, please. Good. Our next research for robots got done. So, are they 75 now? They are. Nice. So they have already gotten 75% faster. And now we wanted to take this. What would it require for us to get more of these? Just steel beams, it seems, and medium containers. I was just low on the steel beams. It seems like it. Where is the steel beam chest? There it is. So yeah, we only have a tiny bit of the production of the steel beams here. More research. Sure, why not? Get it out of the way. We should probably have a chest with some of all of these things. And I guess we could use some loaders for that. Let's do that before making all of these. It takes a total of 3 minutes to make these. Holy shite. Oh, that's because of the steel beams, but we already have those. Or we should have at least. Let's just pick up these gears. Just making room for some resources here. Actually, these should be provider chests because we don't want them to store junk in them. And good, they work like the loader redux loaders. In that they'll snap on themselves. How about if we do that? Nice. Easy loaders. I guess now it would have been nice to have these automated, but it's not like we're going to use it that much, I don't think. Of course, we will use them for our train depots as well, so maybe we should just do this. It needs belts though, that sucks a bit. Can we do it together with our automated belts somehow? They need to get stuff off of that, which is a bit annoying. It could also do something weird like passing this. Over to somewhere else. Well, I guess this will just be small chests, but then we can't do this, that sucks. Please wait a bit. So how about we just... No, we can't just move this over one tile, then the belt is in the way. Do that, of course. Do we have anything important over here? No. So let's use a bit of time on this. So we also need to bring over some of the gear wheels though. But maybe that's okay. Could we do something smart here? Please stop again for now. You need to be producing these. And then you just need the gear wheels. Is it possible to reserve spots in a chest? It is not. Too bad. Otherwise we could just have passed some of the gear wheel through this. And we can't both have one of these and a normal inserter here with a belt. I'm sure that's an easy way to do this and I'm just overcomplicating it. Oh, stop it. Stop it, I said. What have I got that I shouldn't have? These I don't need. Electronic components I do need. I should have a request for that, shouldn't I? Yeah. Don't need these in my inventory. I don't need that. Maybe it's just, well, I don't need that shit. All that. So all of the junk I picked up, I probably thought that the logistic robots would get rid of, but I was wrong. Because I haven't set this up in the logistics system. This seems to be a bit better though. Why? I shouldn't have this in my inventory either. Can we just junk that, please? Good. So, an easier way to do this. Can we maybe just fit this in? Right here somewhere. We can actually. I know it's a bit ugly, but sometimes ugly is okay. Where do we want to output this though? Let's just make more ugly stuff, cause why not? And of course I want a stack of those at all times then. Now for the tier 2s of these. I'll probably just have to handcraft those then. Okay, more research. Should we be working towards the next science type? I guess. If there's not anything else, something like this would also be good. And we should probably put a limit on these chests we have up here. Just so we don't starve the whole factory for all of this stuff. Are we still using all of our stone for our landfill? Apparently, yeah. Is the limit not high enough or low enough? Probably not. Let's just have one chest. Half chest. Half a line, sorry, in a chest. I'm rambling. Let's grab some more of these and then we should be good. I guess we should start making more warehouses as well. So, one of the questions we have to ask ourselves now is that do we want to just do like this and unload with inserters? And I think that is what we want. Or do we want to move them down one tile and unload with loaders? This could be 6 blue belts or whatever. However high our belts go in this. But it's small room and I think it's a bit much and taking advantage of loaders a bit too much. In a way that we don't really need. So this, I guess, is our base depot. And I guess we just take one output from each of them. Unless we want to reserve space for... for 8 lines instead of just 4. Would that be necessary? Well, it's not like we're going to have that many depots in this, I don't think, in this mod. It's not like Bob's where you add everything from platinum to silicon to all sorts of stuff. You'll just have coal, iron, copper, stone, rare metals, and maybe something I am forgetting. So we could just add more coal depots or iron depots or whatever we want. So I think we'll just go with 4. But shouldn't we really be doing this with red belts? Well, maybe not at the coal depot. Yeah, honestly, we should. So let's get to that. Oh, there we go. Should we be balancing these, or should we use inserters between them to balance the warehouses? I guess we could just put a balancer here. We have enough space, right? So not. Like that. Then we just need red outputs as well. Good. So this should be our coal bus depot, I guess, or coal depot. I always forget how I usually name these. I guess this is bus coal depot. And of course, since this is a coal depot, we also need to output a line of fuel for all of the depots from here. Unless we want to... oh, we actually haven't found out if we can use coal for... or coke for fuel. Oh, I haven't set my hotkeys for entering stuff, apparently. Let's just do that. I usually use a mouse button for that. I don't want to move my hand all the way over to the enter key. Wait, what? So that is also set to open inventory or something, apparently. Oh. Mouse button 4, yeah. Close window is also mouse button 4. Oh, we'll just have to... no, how do you unset? Right mouse button to clear, okay. Well, I guess it can still be close window if we want to. Confirm this, please. Enter, good. And it still works for that. How about if we are both in a train and have something open? It will just... close the window, good. So our coke will work as a fuel source for trains. Seems pretty damn slow though, but I guess that's because we only have one of the trains fueled. Or maybe we just need to input some additional electric engines. Wait, electric engines. So they need a power supply, I guess. For example, our portable generators then, and then they'd still need coal or whatever fuel we use. Okay. Let's have you go to that and empty your cargo. Go. Good. We could also move all of this up. How is the next? Yeah, so that could have been here. We can move this up by moving this output over to this side. I think we want to do that. Let's do it. Just to save two tiles. Then of course we haven't got the space for this balancer, but maybe that's okay. Oh yeah, then we need this instead. Do we have room for the balancer? Nope. Exactly not. This looks so much like there's still rocks on the ground, but there just isn't. I guess we just do something like this. Should we just move it one tile out? I think we should. Because then we have room for signals here. And I guess we'll just balance these with inserters then. That's okay. Next research. I guess we can get this as well. Then we are down to the utility tech card stuff. And that is sort of where I want to go. Good. So this is our coal depot. Now for all of these, we need a stagger for the trains. Let's just have a look here. You need to go out that way. We want this to come down the same way. Also need more tracks than just this one. So they should only leave the stagger if their depot is clear and ready to accept them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so we need them to be longer. Let's just check this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so the sixth would go around there. Let's have them a bit closer. To the end, because I've found a couple of times that they do need to be a little bit longer than the trains, because apparently the trains doesn't stop at exactly the same point every time. Good, so that's our stagger, and we need to signal the actual depot like that. And I guess we signal out of the depot as well. Like that. And out here somewhere we will have a T-junction onto our main rail, but it's probably quite a ways away. But unfortunately, that's all we have time for in this episode, so thank you all for joining me, and I'll see you next time. Bye!